Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to Fenway Park.
It's another night that reminds us how fortunate we are to live in this city.
Welcome to Foxborough's Gillette Stadium.
There's a drive to deep right center. This may be gone. Brad Bay back there watching. Oh, good. And we do.
Gets it out deep and Havlicek steals it.
Bobby Orr, behind the net to Sanderson, Orr! Bobby Orr! Orr to the Boston Bruins! And Orr from Stanley Cup!
There it goes, a long drive, if it stays fair, home run!
Now that's a steal by Burr, underneath the DJ, lays it in! White has 1 second left, what a play by Burr!
His postseason career 8-0. That's the best start ever. England Patriots will be the first dynasty of the 21st century.
The Yankees know they're about to play a game they cannot lose. If the Red Sox win this game, this would be one of the great sports stories of all time.
Perhaps this is the way the curse has to end. This final exorcism, coming back from 3-0 like no team has ever done in baseball history.
Boston has written another chapter into their tortured history. A stunning rally from 3 games down to their arch rivals to become the first team in Major League history to come back and force a 7th game.
Here's David Ortiz, the big hulking left-hand hitter. And Brown deals.
Ortiz blasts one. Right.
Run, they lead it 6-0.
And the Red
selfish basketball.
The end of the first overtime, tied at 95. Tears. Looking. Gets it in. Ray Allen for the game. Knocks it down! Protected by Eddie House. Picked off by Tears. Ray Allen for the game. Got it! At the buzzer!
Thank you.
history books from 0-3 down.
Shadow. Divides runner and finisher. Then and now, hurt and healing. The line connects the fear and the will, the few and the many, the memory and the city.
Dawn's early light, what so proudly we hailed as the twilight's last gleam, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous time o'er the red cross he washed. We're so gallantly streaming, and
this our fucking city. And nobody gonna dictate our freedom. Stay strong. Thank you.
Champions. That's awful. Absolutely awful.
There's going to be some loud music out there. There's going to be people questioning play calling, personnel grouping. That's not going to go away until you fix it. It's not.
And we sit with the quarterbacks and the head coaches every week. And when we sat with Tom Brady, we've done this for a lot of years. Tom was tight. He was aggravated. He was not happy with the way things are going offensively. And you see it, this is as frustrated as I've ever seen Tom Brady in Washington since 2000.
He's struggling himself, and they've got a long way to go to solve their problems on offense. They're not running the ball. They're not pass protecting. They can't stretch the field, and here's Jimmy Garoppolo.
Tom Brady was benched. For all of you out there in the world, Tom Brady was benched. It happens to each and every quarterback in the league. Now,
I'm so concerned that I'm going to say publicly, I'm not sure if he's in decline.
Tom Brady was benched for his ineffective play. Garoppolo got in there and moved the ball downfield and got the ball in the end zone. If this continues on for another 5 or 6 weeks, believe the rumblings will start that this could be Tom Brady's last year in New England. I put it out there first.
Jay?
If you don't understand.
Tom Brady's last year in New England?
This could be, if this goes on for about 6, 7 more weeks, there'll be rumblings about maybe is this it for Tom Brady.
Are you crazy, dude? We saw a weak team, the New England Patriots. Let's face it, they're not good anymore.
Yeah, well, we're on to Cincinnati. We're on to Cincinnati.
What do you think having a 37-year-old?
We're on to Cincinnati. It's nothing about the past, nothing about the future. It's right now we're preparing for Cincinnati.
Teammates, and we made Tom Brady look like Tom Brady after you guys were criticizing him all week. The fans, everything, and it feels so good, and he's such a leader, and he went over 50,000 yards today. He's an unbelievable player, and I'm so glad to play with him.
We're certainly not big on individual stats around here, but 50,000 yards, Tom.
And welcome to Super Bowl 49.
Getting a critical mass now at 11:15 left in this football game.
The signature play of the last Super Bowl came on that 3rd and 14 play.
Hanging in, despite a huge hit from Cam Chancellor.
It's a money catch right there.
Tom Brady and the Patriots looking for a fourth quarter drive to take the lead here at Super Bowl 49.
Best quarterback that we've ever seen play the game.
Hands down.
I've said it right before I got to New England. Hands down, the greatest ever. I had in return for grace.
It's a beautiful day. No! Patriots! They're back in the lead! It's Super Bowl 49!
With PC Tire! What do you do in life? You go right to people that you can depend on.
Russell in the pocket. Russell for Kearse, and it's broken up again. And is it, but somehow, oh, did he wind up with a football?
I think Butler hit it, and it fell right back down to the ground. Unbelievable. How many different plays are the Patriots going to have like this? Yep. Mario Manningham, David Tyree.
Right. This was,
and now a Kearse.
This was where Tyree had the helmet catch.
But they're not in yet.
It's on his mind. It has to be. Here he goes. Beast mode. To the half-yard line. And now New England has to think about taking a timeout. You bleed the clock all the way down. They're bleeding it right down. Down to half a minute. Second and goal. Baldwin sets up on the left. Play clock at five. Pass is intercepted at the goal line by Malcolm Butler. Unreal.
Touch me. Take me to that other place. Release me. I know I'm not a hopeless case. What you done?
Sick. I said from the start, the Wells report was full of inaccuracies and inconsistencies and overstatements, all geared toward railroading Tom Brady into being the scapegoat, the fall guy, for all historically that the Patriots have done wrong and cheating all the way back to Spygate. Everyone in the NFL, around the NFL, believed that somehow the Patriots were cheating with the footballs, deflating the footballs. I don't believe Tom Brady had any knowledge of deflating football.
People aren't stupid. This is America. You can't lie. You're a liar.
Brady's just about done. It could be his next game he plays. It could be a year from now. But he is going to fall off a cliff. Tom Brady is going to be a bum in short order.
I believe that Tom Brady will come back with a vengeance. I think he is ready to wreak revenge on the National Football League for Deflategate, and he's going to take it out on opponent after opponent after opponent. And we all know Tom Brady with chip on shoulder can be a force of nature.
And I recognize you have what I've been wanting since that record that Adina Howard had. Pop it fast to impress her. She rolling, I'm holding my scrotum, imposing. This voice here is golden, so fuck y'all, I goes in. And all my life I want money and power. Respect my mind or die from less shout. I pray my dick get big. reach the Eiffel Tower so I can fuck the world for 72 hours. Goddamn, I got bitches. Damn, I got bitches. Damn, I got bitches. Wifey, girlfriend, and mistress. All my life, I want money and fun. Respect my mind, no, nigga, it's go time. I'm rolling, don't with a good grind. And I'm running, hope with a big time. That's a relay race with a bouquet. They say, can you go marry mine?
Time to play football. The three-time Super Bowl MVP, Tom Brady, who has virtually every record for a quarterback.
This is the draft report on you. Basically, it goes poor build, skinny.
So Tom Brady faces an uphill battle now.
Lacks great physical stature and strength.
Lacks mobility and ability to avoid the rush.
He was skinny, slow.
Right.
Brady leads the Wolverines back.
The most underrated college quarterback in the country, Tom Brady.
At the combine, when you watch Tom, you saw this tall, gangly-looking kid. Looked like having ever seen a weight room.
His 40 time and that vertical jump, in 32 years of doing this, we talked about 576 quarterbacks. He was number 576.
Does he wow you throwing the ball? Mm-mm. There were some other guys that could shoot it.
What?
Tim Duncan, Tom Brady, the greatest, most coachable great players of my lifetime. Once you're great, having somebody to tell you you're not always great is not the easiest thing to do, and Duncan and Brady set the bar.
What a cut!
I thought I saw the symbolic end of Tom Brady.
Touchdown, Atlanta!
What is this going to end up being, like 35-10? Are they going to bring that f***ing bench in?
End zone. Side of the Patriots offensive line, pass is picked, intercepted.
When he leaps out to the best of his ability and he comes up empty as the DB runs by him and he lays there, I thought that was the end.
And the Falcons add to their lead. Alford with a pick six.
Tom Brady is overrated.
Two images that I'm going to remember for a very, very long time. After the pick six in the first half, it was 21 to nothing. They cut to Brady on the bench, head down.
Yes.
2:21 left in the first half. Here is Coleman, end zone, touchdown.
And then, for sure, it was game over when the Falcons scored to make it 28-3. With 8:31 left in the third quarter.
It made people think like, oh my God, Tom Brady has fallen off a cliff and it's over.
Like a laser, eye to eye, and he said, that's right, and I'm the best decision this organization has ever made.
And then here comes Brady.
He doesn't have the strongest arm, but he's got the greatest will and pre-snap, drive, focus, endurance, discipline, efficiency. Things that don't sell on the Kardashian show, but things that provide him with an edge on every other competitor.
I wasn't even saying that we were coming back. I was, well, maybe they'll make it a little respectable. I don't know.
Touchdown!
This Patriots crowd just took over the stadium.
It's hit. Ball is out.
And they got the fumble sack.
Hightower knocked it
and
out.
They showed Brady's reaction. That was the first time I actually thought the Pats had a chance.
It's very hard to imagine anyone thinking at 28-3, with 23 minutes left in this game, that the Patriots could come out of their doldrums and really start attacking.
This is four down territory.
It's simply through the force of Tom Brady's will.
First down.
Folks, it's not even a debate anymore. There is no more debate. People don't do their homework if they do debate.
He is the greatest quarterback that has ever played.
That's the GOAT, like the GOAT all time. Not just any position, every position.
From 48-3, I just can't imagine another quarterback who could have done that.
It's the ball to the Patriots. It's a big two-point conversion here to really apply the pressure on the Falcons.
Kevin Falk play right there. Now we got a ball game, folks.
It's good. James White, it's a one-score game in Super Bowl 51.
Tell him, Colin Kyle Shanahan, do not take a sack.
Opportunity missed after that incredible catch by Julio Jones.
Oh, it was such a good drive for Atlanta.
Now they're giving the ball back, and they're going to put Tom Brady in position.
They go 91 yards here. They'll have a chance to tie it. And he's out of bounds with another first down.
New England not only mounted a comeback, but played a virtually flawless last 45 minutes. Spearheaded once again by the GOAT, the greatest quarterback I've ever seen.
There have been seven comebacks of 25 points or more in NFL history. 15,000 games, only seven.
And we are at the two-minute warning.
The greatest performance I've ever seen.
Ryan, finish off this comeback.
He's right in there with Babe Ruth, Muhammad Ali, Michael Jordan, and Tom Brady. Those are the four guys on my Mount Rushmore.
Tom Brady now, somehow, is over 400 yards passing in this game.
Tom Brady threw for 246 yards in the fourth quarter alone.
Touchdown, James White!
That's Clay Thompson. That's unbelievable.
Now the biggest two-point attempt in the history of the Patriots franchise. This is a tie game. Don't ever count Tom Brady out.
Best ever? Best ever in my book. It's the best I've seen. And he's put on a show here in the last 30 minutes of this ball game and to climb back in it.
The word of Matthew Slater, heads win the coin toss.
Still does carry that chip on his shoulder. He's carried it around his entire career. It's driven him. It's what's made him great.
The opening kickoff to the first ever overtime in Super Bowl history. A rally that was next to impossible, more than improbable.
Julian Edelman.
To me, he was so great late last night in that game that he rendered the Deflategate saga irrelevant.
But that was mythical. That's Halo stuff. That's Zaire. That's 104 hit and jumpers. It's the first time I walked out and I'm like, he's floating to that locker room.
And he was as great as you could possibly be. In the history of pro football, who's had a fourth quarter?
No.
You know what my favorite ring is? The next one. That's my favorite.
Diving to the goal line! And a title for the Patriots!
I can't believe it!
They have completed the greatest comeback in Super Bowl history. Led by the greatest quarterback.
One more in New England, and you got it.
But a lot has transpired during the last 2 years. And I don't think that needs any explanation. This is unequivocally the sweetest.
The
it sure looks like Boston is the team of the future.
He's only going to get better. That's the scary part.
Falling too fast to prepare for this. Tripping in the world could be dangerous. Everybody circling as vultures. Negative, nepotist. Everybody waiting for the fall of man. Everybody praying for the end of times. Everybody hoping they could be the one. I was born to run, I was born for this. Whip, whip, run me like a racehorse. Pull me like a ripcord. Break me down and build me up. I wanna be the slip, slip. Word upon your lip, lip. Let it that you rip, rip. Break me down and build me up. Whatever it takes. Cause I love the adrenaline in my veins. I'll do whatever it takes. Cause I love how it feels when I break the chains. I'll do whatever it takes. I take it to the top. I'm ready for whatever it takes. Cause I love the adrenaline in my veins. I do what it takes. Got a fear of being typical. Looking at my body feeling miserable. Always hanging on to the visual. I wanna be invisible. Looking at my ears like a martyrdom. Everybody wants to be a part of them. Never had enough from the prodigal son. I was born to run, I was born for this. Whip, whip, run me like a racehorse. Pull me like a ripcord. Break me down and build me up. I wanna be the slip, slip. Word upon your lip, lip. Letter that you rip, rip. Break me down and build me up. Whatever it takes. Cause I love the adrenaline in my veins. I do whatever it takes. Cause I love how it feels when I break the chains. I do whatever it takes. Oh, take me to the top. I'm ready for whatever it takes. Cause I love the adrenaline in my veins. I do what it takes. Falling too fast to prepare for this. Tripping in the world could be dangerous. Everybody circling as vultures. Negative, nepotist. Everybody waiting for the fall of man. Everybody praying for the end of times. Everybody hoping they could be the one. I was born to run, I was born for this.
Whip, whip, run me like a racehorse. Pull me like a ripcord. Break me down and build me up. I wanna be the slip, slip. Word upon your lip, lip. Let it that you rip, rip. Break me down and build me up. Whatever it takes. Cause I love the adrenaline in my veins. I'll do whatever it takes. Cause I love how it feels when I break the chains. I'll do whatever it takes. Oh, I take me to the top. I'm ready for whatever it takes. Cause I love the adrenaline in my veins. I'll do what it takes.